So let's discuss about recurrent urinary tract infections. So we will discuss definition and treatment, okay? So what is definition? So if a woman has two or more episodes in 6 months or three or more episodes in a year, then it is said to be recurrent, okay? And treatment, first of all, we try behavioral modifications before trialing antibiotics, okay? So what are the things that fall under behavioral modifications, like increased fluid intake and early post-coital voiding, okay? So voiding after coitus and avoidance of spermicides, okay? So post-coital prophylaxis for women with cystitis episodes that are temporally associated with sex, and continuous prophylaxis for other women, okay? So we give post-coital prophylaxis as a single post-coital dose of antibiotics, single post-coital dose of antibiotic to women with cystitis episodes that are temporally associated with sex, and whereas we give continuous prophylaxis. So what I am telling about prophylaxis means I am talking about antibiotic prophylaxis and continuous antibiotic prophylaxis for other women, okay. So continuous prophylaxis for other women, and we choose between nitrofurantoin and cotrimoxazole, okay? So we choose between these two, and we reevaluate whether to continue antibiotic prophylaxis after 3 months. So after initiating this antibiotic prophylaxis, we follow up patients after 3 months, and we again reevaluate whether to continue or not. Most of the women need to continue, because if they discontinue it, they again have cystitis or infections, okay? And dose of these antibiotics is generally lower than those required for treatment. So that dose for prophylaxis is lower than required for treatment, okay? So I am again reiterating, post-coital prophylaxis or single post-coital dose of antibiotic may be more effective method of prevention than continuous prophylaxis in women who have cystitis episodes who have temporally related to sex. And before any prophylaxis is initiated, we check a urine culture 1 to 2 weeks after treatment of an acute episode of cystitis to ensure that there is no high-grade bacteriuria. Okay, so let me write it. If I write it, it will become more clear to you. Otherwise, you may not be understanding because I am speaking so fast. So before any prophylaxis or before any antibiotic prophylaxis is initiated, we check a urine culture 1 to 2 weeks after treatment of an acute episode of cystitis, okay, to ensure there is no high grade bacteriuria, okay? So before initiating any antibiotics prophylaxis, we check a urine culture. And after treating acute episode of urinary tract infection, 1 to 2 weeks after that, we check for urine culture to ensure there is no high-grade bacteriuria before initiating antibiotic prophylaxis.